This video is for those students who want to pursue MSc program in India. Here I have discussed the five aspects related to MSc admissions. These are selection of subjects, the nature of program, the name of premier institute and universities, about MSc entrance examinations, and finally the pattern of examinations. The first important thing is selection of subject. But why I am telling this? See, for MSc you have several options. You can opt life sciences, biotechnology, biochemistry, microbiology, bioinformatics, biophysics, virology, neurobiology. You can also opt zoology and botany, agriculture sciences, and many other options also you have, like environmental sciences, food science and nutrition, mass communications, even MBA program in biotech business, agri business, pharma business. So it is very important for you to select subject first. But in the process of subject selection, we should keep following aspect in our mind. And these aspects are your interest in specific subjects, what is your futuristic goal, the broadness of subject. And broadness of subject is also very important. For example, if you have two options, one MSc Life Sciences from JNU and second MSc Biotechnology from JNU. So in this case, the nature of institute is same. But when you will compare the syllabus of life sciences and biotechnology, you will find the differences. So in this situation, I will suggest you to go for the life sciences because syllabus coverage is broad in case of the life sciences. But this is my opinion. And fourth is the institute or university where you want to join. Suppose you have two options. One MSc Biotechnology in less known university. And second is the molecular and human genetics in BHU. In this particular situation, I will suggest you to go for BHU because the name of institution matters. And finally, the level of competition. Suppose you want to take admission in IITs, and for admission in IITs, you have to appear for the entrance examination. And in these conditions, your hard work and your examination temperament will fulfill your desire. So level of competition is also very important. So you should keep in mind these parameters when you are going to select a subject for MSc program. Now understand the nature of program that we can join. At this particular level, we have two options. One is 2 years MSc program, and second option is the 5-year integrated MSc PhD program. But very few universities and institutions are offering integrated MSc PhD program. Most of the universities and institutions are offering MSc program. Here I will provide you the list of premier institutes and universities in India offering MSc program in the field of the life sciences, biotechnology and allied fields. And the screening of the premier institutes and universities are very important for admission in case of the MSc program. So I have made separate lists for life sciences, biotechnology, biochemistry, microbiology, even allied sciences, as well as for botany and zoology. Now suppose if you want to take admission in the field of the life sciences or biological sciences, you have two options. Either you can go for MSc program or you can go for MSc PhD program. Very few universities and institutions are offering MSc program in the field of the life sciences. Here I have listed the name of the few institutions and universities, and the names are mentioned in the random order. So you have options like JNU New Delhi, Devi Ahilya, Indore, Jamia Millia Islamia, New Delhi. You can also take admission in Banasthali Vidyapeeth, Presidency University. And this is not the complete list. Some more universities and colleges are offering the MSc program in the field of the life sciences. So you can explore those universities and institutions. And second is the integrated MSc and PhD program where a student can join. And these institutions are IC Bangalore, TIFR, ICER, Bose Institute, National Institute of Biomedical Genomics. So you have two options. Either you can go for MSc Life Sciences program or you can go for integrated MSc PhD Life Sciences program. Similarly, in case of the biotechnology, there are many options from where you can pursue your MSc biotechnology program. This is not the complete list of the universities and institutions. And again, the name listed here are in random order because there is no such rating with respect to the MSc biotechnology program offered by the different institutions and universities. So you can pursue MSc biotechnology program from AIIMS, South Asian universities, JNU, IITs, BHU, Pune universities, University of Hyderabad, MS University Vadodara, Delhi Universities, Utkal Universities, Guru Nanak Dev University. So there are many universities and colleges from where you can complete your MSc Biotechnology program. Students sometimes get confused when they explore options in MSc Biotechnology. And reason for this confusion is the name of the MSc Biotechnology courses. In case of the MSc Biotechnology, you will get the name like General Biotechnology, Agriculture Biotechnology, Medical Biotechnology, Marine, Bioresource, Industrial. But there is no big difference in the nature of the program at the level of the MSc. So you can choose according to your choice. Similarly, in case of the MSc Biochemistry, we have many good options. Here I have mentioned the name of the few universities and institutions in random order. This is not the complete list. MSc Biochemistry program, you can join in AIIMS, BHU, Pondicherry University, Jamia Millia Islamia, University of Hyderabad, University of Madras. As I told you, this is not the complete list. There are many institutions and universities offering the MSc program in the field of the biochemistry. So similarly, you will get options in case of the MSc Microbiology. Here also, I have listed the name of the few institutions and universities in the random order, like University of Hyderabad, Delhi University, BHU, Kurukshetra University, Central University of Rajasthan, Central University of Tamil Nadu. But apart from MSc Biotechnology, MSc Microbiology, MSc Biochemistry, you have options also in the field of the allied subject. For example, the biophysics from AIIMS, molecular medicine from JNU, biophysics from Jamia Millia Islamia, biomedical sciences from Jamia Hamdard, genetics and plant breeding from ICR, IERI, plant genetic resources, ICR, NBPGR, Department of System and Computational Biology from Hyderabad University, a very good MSc program in the field of the neurobiology from NBRC, molecular and human genetics from BHU, biomedical research from ACBR New Delhi, virology from the National Institute of Virology, genetics from the South Campus Delhi University, and bioinformatics from Jamia Millia Islamia. So MSc program from these institutions are equally good. So at MSc level, you have options to choose allied subjects also. And these allied subjects are offered by the most of the premier institutions in India. MSc zoology and botany are very classical subjects. Most of the universities in India are offering MSc zoology and botany. So it is very difficult to mention the name of the all the universities. But few universities name I have listed here. Again, these names are mentioned here in the random order. You can join MSc zoology and botany in University of Delhi, BHU, Pune University, University of Lucknow, Calcutta University, Mumbai University, University of Kerala, and several other universities. Now let us explore some information related to MSc entrance examination. For admission in MSc program, you have two options. Either you can take admissions in MSc program through the common admission test, or you can go for the institute or university specific admission test. But at the level of MSc, there are very few common admission tests for admission in the MSc program. The most of the institutions and universities are offering their own tests for admission in the MSc programs. So you can choose institute or university specific admission tests based on the nature of the subject. For example, MSc Life Sciences, MSc Biotechnology, MSc Biochemistry, MSc Microbiology. And I have already provided you the list of the institutions and universities offering MSc Life Sciences, Biotechnology, Biochemistry, Microbiology, and Allied Sciences. There are two subjects where you will get the common admission test. One is the Biological Sciences or Life Sciences, and second is the Biotechnology or Allied Field. So for integrated MSc PhD program in the Biological Sciences, so there is a common admission test. And second, for admission in the MSc Biotechnology and some allied field, there are some common admission tests. There are the two common admission tests. One is joint graduate entrance examination for biology and interdisciplinary life sciences. So on the basis of this particular examination, you can take admission in TIFR, ICER, Bose Institute, and National Institute of Biomedical Genomics. Whereas, if you want to join integrated MSc PhD program in IIT Bangalore, so for that you have to appear for the IIT JAM. And score of IIT JAM is only applicable in case of the IIT Bangalore. Similarly, for MSc Biotechnology, you can appear for graduate aptitude test, that is GATB, or IIT JAM. Now first understand the pattern of GATB, because this common entrance examinations offers maximum number of seats. So graduate aptitude test was earlier conducted by JNU in the name of the combined entrance examination for biotechnology. And this is a DBT supported PG program. And this test is organized by the RCB and conducted by NTA. On the basis of the graduate aptitude test, the postgraduate program that you can join is M.Tech Biotechnology and Allied Subjects, M.Sc. Biotechnology and Allied Subjects, M.Sc. Agriculture Biotechnology, M.Sc. Veterinary Science Animal Biotechnology. So, four different types of the program you can join with the help of the graduate aptitude test. As I told you, this particular examination offered the maximum number of seats for admission in the M.Sc. Biotechnology program. The number of seats in the year 2021, it is 1221. But this number is not fixed. And mode of examination, you will find the computer-based. The duration of examination is of 3 hours. And when you will see the pattern of examinations, you will get the questions in two parts, part A and part B. Part A includes 60 multiple choice questions, and from physics, chemistry, mathematics, as well as the biology. And the standard of question, you will find 10 plus 2 level. And there is a provision of negative marking also. So here you will get half negative marking. In case of the part B, you will get the 100 questions from the biology, but you have to answer only 60 questions. And these questions you will find of bachelor level. And each correct answer you will get the 3 marks. And there is the provision of negative marking also here. For each wrong answer, 1 mark will be deducted. So this is the pattern of the exam, sir. In case of the IIT JAM, you will also get the computer-based test. But in this case, you will get the only 60 questions of 100 marks. The subject that you have to cover for the IIT JAM is the biology, chemistry, mathematics and physics. Mathematics and physics of 10 plus 2 level, chemistry and biology of 10 plus 2 plus 3 level. If you will cover the analytical techniques like chromatography, spectroscopy, spectrometry under biophysics, in that particular situation, then chemistry you will find of 10 plus 2 level. Here the questions are divided in 3 sections, section A, B and C. In case of the section A, you will get the 10 MCQs, multiple choice question. Out of 4 options, 1 will be the correct option. And these 10 MCQs, you will find 1 mark each. And there is a provision of negative marking. In section A, again, you will get the 20 MCQs of 2 marks each. And there is a negative marking of 2 upon 3. In section B, you will get the multiple select questions. And there will be 10 multiple select questions, where more than one answer may be correct. But there is no negative marking in case of the section B. In case of the section C, out of the 20 questions, 10 questions you will get of 1 mark each and 10 questions you will get 2 marks each. So this is the scheme and pattern of the IIT JAM. In the case of the joint graduate entrance examination for biology and interdisciplinary life sciences, here also you will find the mode of examination is computer based, but total number of questions you will get only 60. Time duration is of 2 hours. There are the 4 sections. Section A includes the questions from the general science, section B from physics, section C from chemistry, or section D from biology. In every section, you will get the 15 questions. Out of 15 questions, 10 MCQs of 1 mark each and 5 MCQs of 2 mark each. Total marks is 80 and there is a provision of negative mark, there is a half negative. Now, most important thing, what should be the strategies of the examination preparation? The first important thing, when you are going to start the preparation. Because if you will start the preparation early, then you will get the maximum time for the coverage of syllabus, the practice of questions. And second is the selection of subject domain. Because at the level of MSc, you have several options. You can take admission in life sciences, biotechnology, biochemistry, microbiology, botany, zoology, even bioinformatics. So you first select the subject domain where you want to pursue your MSc program. And third important thing is the selection of the examination types. Because most of the institutions are offering the entrance test for admission in the MSc program. So it is very difficult to appear for the, all the different examinations. So you first select what are the different entrance examinations for admissions in MSc program you want to target. So this is very important one if you want to be focused. After selecting the examination type, then you can explore the pattern of the examination. What is the pattern of examination? Just before this particular slide, I mentioned the pattern of examination with respect to IIT JAM, GATB. When you will understand the pattern of examination, then the next step is to know the syllabus of the examination. Because when you will understand the syllabus of examination, then you can start the PPSL. Otherwise, the things will be completely random. And there are so many universities, institutions offering so many programs in the field of the life sciences and biotechnology. So in this particular condition, to gather the information is also very important. But question arises from where we should gather the information, because internet is flooded with the information, but you cannot rely on all the information. So for any information for a specific examination, you go for the authorized website. From the authorized and authentic website, you can get the correct information. After these steps, then you make an information chart. In that particular information chart, it should be mentioned which subject domain you are targeting. For example, you are targeting the MSc Biotechnology program and MSc Life Sciences program. So that should be mentioned. Again, MSc Life Sciences and Biotechnology program is offered by the many organizations. Then you should select the examination type, and that should be mentioned in your information chart. You also mention the pattern of examination. To some extent, you also mention the syllabus of the examination. And something also very important to highlight, that is the date of notification of application form, date of examination. So these information should be in your information chart.